So pleased to see you all here.
First, I'll have to tell you something which is coming in a new bracket. We have a situation here at hand. I'll have to give a speech. That's true. But then I open a bracket for you. We had a plan for a party. And in that party, we were expecting about 30 people, 40 people. You can imagine what we have at hand now. If we knew that we would have such a number, perhaps things would have been done in a better way. But that notwithstanding, this is a push for us. We're going to use this as a push so that next time we will think big and act even bigger. Thank you very much. Okay, the message for tonight is happiness. Such a very short word, happiness. The most expansive thing, this is my opinion. I'll give you the floor, you all, to think about your opinion. And you can judge mine with yours later. But to my opinion, this is the most expensive thing in the whole world. Happiness. It's not a Ferrari. It's not a mansion. It's not as many wives as you can get. It's not super girlfriends or thousands of kids. It's that simple word, happiness. It comes in various formats and forms. People die for it. People cry for it. People smile for it. People are willing to destroy the whole world just for it. The closest example is what is happening now between Russia and Georgia and that little part they call Ossetia or something. Russia wants to be happy by owning the world. Georgia wants to be happy by sitting in their little corner. So you see what the word happiness that means. Okay, thank you very much. So I come now to our point. Ladies and gentlemen, dearest invitees and guests, fellow Kumbans, under the banner of the president of this set organization, I wholeheartedly welcome you all to our summer quest for happiness. This is a summer quest for happiness. We want to be happy, at least this summer, at least from this summer onwards. First, a recapitulation dive into the word happiness and the synonyms that centers around it. In the 18th century, the quest of happiness, or for happiness, or for a logical, scientific, objective meaning of the word, of the meaning of, sorry, I think it again. In the 18th century, the quest for a logical, scientific orientation of man in the world was begun. And one of the greatest philosopher of that time, who happened to be a French, and his name was Epicurus. In English, Epicurus, in French, Epicure. He said that happiness is the greatest thing that a human being needs in this world. And after this assertion, the world turned France a place for pleasure. If you take a look at our society today, people who are trying to get romantic marriage, they're going to Paris. People who are trying to be happy, according to them, they're going to Paris. They're going to France. So France at that time was looked upon as a country where people are just happy. They just want pleasure. They don't want anything else, only pleasure, which leads to happiness. So the real good life of man on earth, as he said, is that of pleasure, is that of happiness. This means that pleasure is the sole goal. It may sound funny, but this school of thought a young girl of 4 years old, a child, tries to be happy by playing with her toys, her dolls, plaiting the hair, doing all sort of things. Just take a look and watch what this girl is doing. Don't talk to her, don't talk to her. And you'll see how she's trying
man
to
make herself
happy all alone.
That's what it is.
Similarly, a young boy, say 4 years old, is also seeking happiness. But this time around, playing with toy cars.
You see, not even edit the speech.
Again, a young man seeks a beautiful girl's heart by thinking.